Some of us, in the very beginning of this big imtihan, is global, is universal imtihan, is affecting almost everyone. Some people showed happiness and mentioned this is iqab from Allah, this is punishment from Allah to those people who denied, who tortured, who put the Muslim in troubles. It could be, but we should not, we the Muslims should not show any happiness. Even for our enemies to be in troubles, we should have Rahmah. We've been sent Rahmah. We should have these doors open for them to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We recite in Surah Al-Buruj. Surah Al-Buruj. إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق. What else can be said? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He opened the doors of tawbah for those who put the people of Iman in ukhdood, in trench, and they kick them into the fire in ukhdood. And then thumma lam yatubu, they had not made tawbah. So tawbah is still open. Subhanallah. The troubles, the torture that we get through, we have to ask ourselves, why? Why the Muslims are putting us in troubles? What can we do for them? Is it only this punishment for them? Hasn't affected the Sahn al-Kaaba? The mataf around the blessed, the honored Kaaba, our Qibla? Yeah, Baytullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has not affected the masajid. Hasn't we heard that some masajid, even the adhan, sallu fi buyutikum, pray at your own homes? Have we heard that some masajid may cancel, already cancel, like salatul jum'ah, jum'ah salat? So affecting everyone. Why some of us start feeling happy? Is this the tertib al-sahaba? We have this stand, very iconic, very clear tertib al-sahaba. Sahaba radiallahu anhum had this feeling, bad feeling about the kuffar. Let Allah finish them, let Allah punish them, let Allah. Why? We want them to recognize Allah. We are lacking, we are weak in showing them rahmah, in calling them towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We the khayr ummah, the best ummah, ukhrijat lin nas, where we are from, showing them the rahmah. وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent rahmah للعالمين. They are people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is their Rabb. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Al-Alameen, both in Surah Al-Fatiha and in Surah Al-Anbiya, rahmah للعالمين. Same للعالمين. My dear brothers and sisters, we have to understand our responsibility. Our responsibility is not just to close our doors and enjoy our iman and dhikr and salat and go to Baytullah al-Haram and enjoy ourselves. We've been sent to khayra ummah, ukhrijat, been sent out linnas. We forget our job, our responsibility. When he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about khayru nas, the best of people, he said, anfa'uhum, the most beneficial to them. Where are you? If this is why we are bringing this tartib al-sahaba, we bring in this wajibah, duties of the Anbiya alayhi wa sallam, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam presented them in the best manner. So we ourselves to have the full deen and will not be shy, will not make our beards a fashionable beard. So try to please other cultures and other styles. Some of us are still scared to put a topi or headgear on their heads, while they wanted and worked to get their female to cover their heads and even cover their faces. The face veil. We have to understand where we are. How strong are we in our Iman as a Muslim? And then how strong of showing in a practical way Rahmah to our neighbors, to our colleagues, to everyone in the world, that Allah is His Rabb, Rabbil Alameen, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam send Rahmah lil Alameen, the whole world. What are these three? The first is Da'wah. يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِ We hear this few times. Da'wah. وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ Purify their hearts. وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ We can ask ourselves, why some of us, if not many, they still working on one or two of these three duties or three jobs of the Anbiya, neglecting the others, have no training for others. Some just keep seeking ilm, keep seeking ilm, keep loading in their minds, knowledge after knowledge, ilm after ilm, information after information. They are dying for that. And may take, okay, I will go and practice some, busy in ibadah. And the da'wah said, what? To do what? There are some people who are walking in the street. Why don't you walk in the street? Why don't you give at least 10% and go? If you got something to learn or to teach, be there. If that is part of your school, of my approach, that let us have the three together. Have the full package of our beloved, our Sayyid Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one with the da'wah, the one who has the ilm and taught us it, and the one who worked sallallahu alayhi wa sallam night and day to purify our souls and hearts and make nothing in our heart but love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love all good for His makhluq, for His creatures. Is that why we go out? That's why we spend time? That's why we say to the brothers and sisters, spend time in da'wah? There is no movement, there is no group are perfect. We do not have imams and awliya everywhere, and sahaba radiallahu anhum are there and here in any movement that to bring Islam back. But look at a movement, look at a group who are trying to give time and to go around the whole world, the whole earth, alhamdulillah. We should go with what? With what mizaj? With mizaj al-anbiya. Mizaj al-anbiya. This is the last to conclude with. Whatsoever happening, face whatsoever happening with the approach, the attitude, the emotions of the Anbiya alayhi salatu salam, and the peak and the top of this, the emotion, the approach, the attitude of our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Would he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam curse? Would he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wait for punishment to come from Allah to his people? How he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put a lot of sabr, a lot of hikmah, a lot of rahmah to many people, to his enemies, to people who plan night and day, how he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forgave, how he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed a big welcome and open doors for those who fought him, caused his beloved people to become shaheed. We know the stories of Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl. We know the Wahshi, the one who martyred Sayyid al-Shuhada, Master of Shuhada, Hamza ibn Abd al-Muttalib, uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We know about Hind, the wife of Abi Sufyan. Let us read the seerah. Let us bring this tartib al-Sahaba. They learned from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our hearts, in our day-to-day life, in our approach attitude.